You're probably too comfortable in your engineering career. So in this episode of the Engineering Career Coach Podcast, I am going to give you 10 scary things that you should be doing in your career to push yourself and take yourself to the next level. Let's do it. All right, so I have the luxury of speaking to many successful engineering professionals through the podcast and the different content channels that we create here at EMI. And one of the things that keeps jumping out at me in terms of what's made them successful is taking risks. They keep telling me that they took risks in their career. They did things that made them uncomfortable, things that were scary to them. So what I thought I would do in this episode is rattle off 10 scary things that you can try in your engineering career to be uncomfortable and to push yourself beyond your current boundaries to help you look back on your career in 10, 20, 30 years and say, you know what, I took that risk and it paid off. All right, so let's run right through these. The first one is to take a risk at work, like giving your boss an idea for a new product or new service, maybe even drawing up a business plan. I'll give you one example. I know some civil engineering professionals right now that drones are becoming very popular, especially in the world of civil engineering and infrastructure. And so some young civil engineers are starting up drone divisions for their companies. They're researching about drones, maybe getting their license, their pilot license for drones, and then they're giving their company an entire new revenue stream. So what can you do for your organization that would drum up more business, improve their bottom line, maybe become a new product offering? It's risky because, you know, you're going to your boss and you're saying, I think I can make this work, and then you're going to have to do it. But if it pays off, it'll be a big win for you and it might be a risk worth taking. Number two, change your living conditions. And I'm gonna flip back and forth between professional and personal in these scary things. You live in the same place maybe for a long time and you become comfortable. Maybe you need to downsize, right? More simple apartment or house, or maybe it's time to upsize, right? You've worked hard, you've saved some money. Sometimes just changing our living conditions can impact the way we work and our careers because we're in a different setting, we're in a different atmosphere. Maybe you're in a different neighborhood now. That can have an impact on you. Number three, just live more simply. I've been doing that myself a little bit, trying to go through my phone and delete a bunch of apps, get rid of a bunch of stuff in the office that isn't necessary, that just kind of adds stress to your life, to your career, right? So think about what are some of the things you can cut out of your life or even your career that aren't adding value and that are just causing stress. It's not easy to do because, again, we get comfortable. We have something in our career that's just always there, right? It's like you have a subscription to some service that just keeps charging you, but you never use it. So how can you cut things out? Number four, get a new certification or license in your career, but tell your boss that you're going to get it to add accountability in. So if you've been wanting to get your professional engineering license or a different accreditation, sign up, tell people in your company that you're going to get it, put the pressure on yourself and get it done. We're getting close to the end of the year here, 2019, and I want to challenge you. I really want you to take one of these after the episode and go after it. Number five, sign up to volunteer for a society activity. For example, maybe you're a member of an engineering association, but you haven't taken the next step yet. So I want you to take the next step. I want you to volunteer to get on a board or a committee or run a local STEM event. Commit to it. Put your name on it and do it. You're going to meet people. You're going to build skills. You're going to become a better speaker, most likely, because of the speaking associated with it. But it's risky because once you commit to that, you've got to get that event done. And I want you to try that. Number six, maybe volunteer to write a series of articles for your company's website, or even more scarier, do a series of videos. I've learned that creating content is a great way to get your mind going and thinking about different things. Can also help you build your expertise, can also help you to get known within your company or your industry if this content gets out there in the right channels. So go up to your marketing department and say, listen, I've got an idea for a good series of articles. I'd like to write them and commit to it. It's uncomfortable. It's scary. Writing a series of articles that's going to be published, but you can do it even if it requires some research in the long run. Again, it can build your own brand in the engineering world. Number seven, commit to doing something physical like running a marathon or having some, you know, weightlifting goals or whatever the case may be. When you push yourself physically, it will help you as well mentally and in your career. Because, you know, whenever we're in physical shape, it keeps us working productively, but also stretching yourself physically, again, keeps you excited, engaged in life on a regular basis. So commit to something like that. You'll also meet friends and colleagues in the process during the training process. Number eight, here's a scary one. ask for a raise. If you think you're worth more than you're getting paid, and that's possible, then come up with a plan of how you can show your supervisor and your company that you are worth more than you're getting paid and ask if they would make an adjustment appropriately based on whatever you feel the value is and they feel the value is. And you know what? It may not work out, but at least they know you're thinking about it and they know that you feel that you have value and you show it to them in that conversation. Number nine, do something epic for your industry. Or for the world, quite frankly. I recently interviewed an engineer for our Women in Civil Engineering series on the Civil Engineering podcast. Her name is Philippa, and if you listen to the Civil podcast, you'll hear her interview soon. She is a British engineer now working in Nepal. And she left her last job to take on this project because she's literally building a road, overseeing the construction of a road between two communities that are not connected in any way right now in terms of infrastructure. So if someone from one community wants to go to the other community, they have to walk for 3 days. As opposed to driving for 4 hours, which is going to happen when she finishes with this project. So I would say that that's pretty epic. Number 10, switch jobs or careers. You can't get much more scarier or uncomfortable than that. And I recently helped an engineer go from one discipline in her industry to another discipline in her industry, from one location in the United States to a completely different location in the United States. And it was all because she said, you know what? I know this is going to be a lot of work and it's going to be difficult for me to make this change, but she enlisted the help of a career coach. We worked together. She did a lot of work and now she is in one of the biggest cities in the United States, working for one of the biggest companies in the discipline that she wanted to get into. And she's building her new career in that industry, all because she did something scary. And she tried to take a career jump at an age when maybe some people wouldn't take it. So those are the 10 things that I have for you. Take a risk at work, give your boss a new product or service, change your living conditions, live more simply, get a new certification, license, or degree, and tell your boss you're gonna do it. Sign up to volunteer for a society, volunteer to write a series of articles or do some videos for your company, commit to something physical like running a marathon, ask for a raise, do something epic for your industry or the world, and lastly, switch jobs or switch careers if you're not happy in your current job. I hope you found these helpful. Please leave some comments below this video on other things that you might think people can do, or on our show notes page for the podcast. You can find all of our content at engineeringmanagementinstitute.org. And again, if you go to our website and you look for the Engineering Career Coach podcast episode number 213, you will find a full summary of all of these points. And until next time, I hope that we can help you continue to engineer your own success.